up, guys? Welcome back. I'm Ansel, and today we're going to talk about The Incredible Hulk number 717, aka the finale to the World War Hulk 2 storyline. First of all, I want to say I still feel it is unjustified that this story was called World War Hulk 2, in the same way that the previous storyline, Planet Hulk 2, which I know it wasn't officially called that way, but let's face it, it was Planet Hulk number 2. I do believe these two stories didn't need to be called this way. I know they need, they have marketing reasons for which they named these stories this way, so they can catch the attention of the buyers a little more, so they can buy them and then they can make more money. I know, it's a business. But it is a little of a letdown, of a disappointment when you read these stories and you see, hey, something like Planet Hulk 2, I'm going to read it and I expect it to be something like the first Planet Hulk. And then you see, no, that's not the case. And then you get World War Hulk 2, and it had a very interesting start. Amadeus Cho was like, I'm the strongest one there is, and I'm also the smartest one there is. I'm your biggest threat. I'm the biggest one in here, and no one will ever have the will and the strength and everything to oppose me. Yeah, interesting start, but then nothing really happened. I mean, the storyline had some interesting issues, and this finale, some interesting facts, and this finale has none of them. There is no real fights in here. Besides the internal one that Amadeus Cho has, and that is the focus of this story, that Amadeus has been denying his inner demons since back when he took the Hulk power from Bruce Banner. He's been saying, I'm not like Bruce, I'm a better Hulk, I'm the totally awesome Hulk, I don't have anything to deal with. But we've been seeing that was not really the case. I mean, we always knew that since the very beginning, but now we see him actually facing these demons, because these demons are the ones that are declaring war on the heroes. So basically, yeah, the issue is mainly about that, the not much action, and then it resolves itself in a way that makes Amadeus Cho grow as a person, which is nice, it's cool, I like his character. But not in a way that lives up to the name that they went with, this World War Hulk 2 thing. But it was pretty entertaining nonetheless. We have a new version of this Hulk. And not only a new version of Amadeus Cho's Hulk, but also a new version of Hulk in general. And this new version of Hulk will stay around, mainly, I believe, in the Champions book that I'm not sure if I will be able to cover up, but because I don't really like it, but maybe I do, maybe I don't, but that's another story. The thing is that in here, we see this thing actually makes sense. It's a way to keep this Hulk around, and now that Bruce Banner is coming back, and it's a way to have this Hulk live and interact and do things at the same time as the other one, without feeling like there are two characters that are too much alike. So I like the change, I like the adaptation, I like this new version of the Hulk, I like where they're going with this character. I don't know if I will follow him, even though I really like Amadeus Cho. I'm more looking forward to the return of Bruce Banner. So I'm going to give this issue 2 Amadeus Cho out of 5, because even though I had fun, I don't think it was very well crafted. I don't think it lived up to its name. And well, let's see where they go with this. So, thank you so much for watching. If you liked anything in this video, let's say that you like how I like Amadeus Cho, then you can click the like button down below or comment on your opinion about this whole World War Hulk 2 naming situation. And well, yeah, that will be all for now. See you next time.